What's up, guys? I'm Jed Abendroth, and this is Big Man Fitness. Before we get started, don't forget to reach on down here, ring that bell for notifications, hit that subscribe button. That way you're always subscribed and you're notified when I put out brand new content every Sunday for this channel. All right, guys, so focusing on motivation. We're getting motivated. We're getting ready to go. So, what's stopping you now? Well, what are you afraid of? Are you afraid of a multitude of things? Are you afraid of it's going to be hard? I can tell you, life is hard. Everything about life is hard. Is it the pain? Is that what you're afraid of? Being sore, your muscles, barely being able to walk. Man, days after, did a heavy leg day this Monday, about Wednesday, I was still barely walking, right? So, is it the pain you're afraid of? Is it the commitment? The commitment to yourself? Are you afraid you're not going to be able to finish out? We're going to discuss all that today on Big Man Fitness. Again, these topics, man, I'm focusing on the fitness side, but it encompasses all of life. And it's very important for everything we do. Again, we've talked about setting up that routine. We've talked about getting motivated and feeling better about yourself and really pushing for that happiness. So, what is it that you're truly afraid of? Why haven't you started yet? Only you can really answer that. But I'm going to go over a couple topics that maybe you're not ready for, or maybe you're not sure what it is that is holding you back, but there is something there holding you back. So, my favorite one, is it the pain? I've talked to so many people that have started and stopped because of how painful it is. Soreness is no joke. Now, of course, with anything, start light. Don't go after the heaviest thing, especially in the gym. We all have that kind of ego inside of us where we want to show off a little bit and not look like we're so far behind. Well, everyone that is there, even the old ladies, you want to show that you can do it. Don't do that. Take it easy. Lightweight, high reps. If you're doing lifting, you're doing yoga, go once or twice a week. Build into it. You're not going to master yoga in a couple weeks, a couple months, heck, really, honestly, a couple years. Take that cycling class, do one a week. Get out there and give it your all once a week. When you get used to it, twice a week. You slowly build into it. You're still going to feel some pain, but I promise you that pain isn't going to be so bad. You'll get used to it. You'll push a little harder. You get a little more pain. It really is not horrible. It's not bad at all, to be honest with you. I enjoy it. But I've gotten to the point where I really embrace being sore. I feel weird if I'm not sore. Literally, healing my knee, doing this little exercises, which I still do. Well, that's not a real, that to me, that wasn't like a good, solid workout. But I still did them. And because of those, got discharged by physical therapy. I'm told I'm allowed to lift. Again, I got to start out light. I did start out light. No weight. Well, low weight. Very high reps. I went as far as I could, not as fast as I could, but I definitely went as far as I could. Well, I don't want to blow my knee out. I want to make sure I'm building proportionately. That's my goal. What is your goal? drop me a comment down below. Let me know what your goals are. Maybe it's something we can all work together. I can help you with. Get you motivated. Get you through the fear of the pain. Again, pain is my favorite part. That soreness. Once you get into it, that pain doesn't hit the next day. Delayed onset muscle soreness. You'll hear people talk about this. DOMS. I get the DOMS. That pain doesn't hit me for... If I work out on Monday, I might not start feeling that soreness, really feeling it till Tuesday night. Really, Tuesday night. Honestly, Wednesday morning. It's just... That's how your body develops. That pain is you tearing down muscles. Whether you're lifting, you're running, you're rowing, you're biking, you're yoga-ing. You know what I mean. That's the muscles breaking down. And of course, now we got to feed our bodies right to build the muscle back up properly. But that's all that pain is. That's all the pain will ever be. It's not something that's going to be there forever. You grow used to it. Before my two injuries that kind of slowed me down, it wasn't even like soreness. It's like my muscles felt heavy. A little heavy today. And I started getting used to that. So the pain, well, the pain is something to be embraced. Just learn to love it. It makes life a lot easier when you understand that pain and you feel that pain and you enjoy that pain. You look for that pain. So that's what you gotta do. Fear of commitment. Everything we love to do in life, we always find ways to set time aside because it's something we really want to do. Well, if you really want to lose weight, get in shape, the multitude of reasons why you want to get into fitness, well, you gotta make that commitment. That commitment is a promise to yourself. You made a commitment to get out of bed to go to work. You make a commitment to have a family, and you're committed to that family and doing everything you can to help that family. Well, make a commitment to yourself. Invest in yourself. I can't make that commitment for you. Only you can make that commitment. Why be afraid of that commitment? Start small, like I was saying earlier with pain. Commit half an hour, one day a week, and go from there. Everybody can find half an hour of their day, whether it's you wake up a little earlier, you do it after work. You stop by the gym on your way home from work. Put in that half hour. And you realize that you like that half hour, make it an hour. There's no set time that you have to work out. You can do it like me, 2:30 in the morning. You can do it at 10 o'clock at night. It's whatever works for you on your schedule. I found my schedule. I find that going to bed early, getting up early, going for my little jog/walk in the evenings, get home, go for my lift, eat dinner, relax, go to bed. That is my, I've made that commitment to myself. I've made that promise to myself. Honestly, I kind of like that promise. I enjoy that promise. I feel better because I keep making strides to get better. I'm bettering myself through a commitment to myself. I've made a promise to myself. There's no greater reward than having that promise to yourself. We make promises all the time, right? Promise to meet up with friends at the bars. Promise to meet up with family at family gatherings. I'm about to say social gatherings. I don't know if we really have those right now, but hey, those will probably come back at some point. You're going to make promises for those. Promise your family to take them to soccer practice or Little League. Make the promise for yourself. Promise yourself. I, again, cannot do this for you. You have to make up your mind. This is something you want, something you're willing to work towards, and just do it. Again, guys, there's a multitude of fears. Are you afraid you're going to change? Well, I kind of hope so. There's a mental change you're going to have to go through. And hopefully your body's going through a physical change. Enjoy, embrace that change. You don't want to end up being that person that you were if you're willing to make, if this is something you want. Obviously, there's something about the other person, the other you don't like. Do you want to stay that way? Do you want to continue being that person and just being that way? Well, that's why I decided to make the change. I woke up one day, looked in the mirror, realized how much I had ballooned. I'm done. I need to do something or I am literally going to die. That was the decision I decided to make. All right, guys. Well, that's what I got for this week. I know I can probably actually shoot a second video of this, and there may be a part two coming soon. But I don't want to make it too long. So, guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to reach out to me, bmfjed@gmail.com. You can find me on Facebook, Jedediah Raymond Abendroth. Drop me some comments down below. Let me know what your fears are going into any type of fitness program, fitness routine. Again, I am not a licensed trainer, dietitian, anything like that. These are just the things I go through. These are the thoughts that I have throughout my journey. Started at 462 and I'm on my way down. You can find me on Instagram or Twitter at JedFDK. And as always, guys, I will see you next week. Peace.